I'm seriously, like, is this game, like, kind of small for you? Or is it sort of normal?
Yeah, I mean, it's decent for, you know, for No Limit, it's pretty big.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, there's short take games that are bigger, but often, obviously when we're playing Sky High, a lot of times I don't have all of myself.
Yeah.
Here I have all of myself, so I don't
know. That was a question that I ignored from, let me see, but there it is, all of
myself. Actually, well, no, today I grabbed a seat that someone else had a chance of, so I gave him a little sweat, but basically on TV, I don't think I've ever had less than 90% of myself.
Let's go.
I'm not sure. I mean, there's probably one aberration where I somehow had 80 or something, but...
Persian Punisher would like to know if anybody has a very different persona off camera versus on camera on high stakes poker, specifically this season or last.
I think most people have at least a bit different. Phil Hemme is one of the ones that has the same one. It's crazy.
It's amazing.
But yeah, I think most people have a different one. Rick has the same one.
Yeah. Yeah, he does.
He's just the same dude.
Yeah.
I would say most people have to.
Kind of you, by the way. You're sort of yourself.
Yeah, I think I'm like aware the camera's there. I mean sometimes I'll do a crazier bluff or something.
Sure,
shit,
but know? Like but your demeanor, you don't play up to the, you know, you're not like, you do poker-wise. I mean, like you said, I mean, do you ever feel like if I dust super hard, it's just not that big a deal for you? Like, it's kind of good? Like, did you have that going into the first time? Like,
first time for sure.
Like, if I go and just dust it, life goes on. I'm still going to be getting it done, kind
of. Well, and now a lot of the games I'm playing are more private.
Yeah.
So some of those guys, maybe I'll see this once, if at all. The games I used to play, a lot of times it was online. And I was thinking, like, oh, if I'm wrong on this crazy bluff, well, at least I'll get some more action, you know?
Tournaments. You ever see tournaments? And do tournaments ever, like, tickle your fancy? Or you really, like, are known to kind of avoid them, sort of?
I mean, I like them.
Full deck, I'm talking about. I know she like big short deck stuff.
Well, I still like full deck tournaments. I don't like the way... I think there needs to be more policing. Even Triton, I don't think we've done... quite enough.
As far as...
the fucking... everyone's just staring you down.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, I don't mind if it goes, you know, a post-flop hand. You want to take your 20, 30 seconds every decision. But when it's like, raise, next to act, take 30 seconds, take them. And it's just like, come on, you can't do that shit every time.
Unspoken, almost. Like, yeah. Quicker shot clocks, would you like?
Yeah, that's what Triton did. And I mean, I think Triton did some pretty good stuff. I think actually Caracas's thing, the super heavy roller ball, I think they do. I haven't played
with
one of
the time matches. Extensions is kind of cool. Yeah, if you run out of it. Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, I think you need that kind of stuff because poker's like, I always say there's kind of two classes of people. And most people are some in both, but some people play for mainly enjoyment, some play for fun. Some play mainly for enjoyment, some play for money. And people are in one camp or the other more. It's a spectrum, and if you make it like 100% competition, that's just not like, I'm not saying, I expect at the final table, people are gonna take it super serious, people are gonna stare, but when you have like first level of a tournament, you raise and, you know, Makita's the one everyone rags on because he always does it. Makita just stares you down. You're like, come on, man. You know, and I actually like the dude. I don't mind him. But at the poker table, I'm like, oh, man. Like, give me a table change.
Well, he's got the Hugo Boss going on, the shades. He's playing perfect. He's fucking, he's tough, man. Yeah. No, but I agree.
I think that's one thing I like about cash games is there's this pressure on people to try to be cool.
Yeah.
And I think that's kind of an important thing at poker. But you want poker to be a social thing.
Yeah. And I know it is. I mean, it... yeah.
I was asked this question with Paul once. We were like, somehow they were interviewing us together. And Paul had this answer I'd never even heard him say before. And just like answered, I think on the spot, he was just like, yeah, poker is this great way of people coming together and different cultures meeting and this kind of stuff. And obviously I'm mainly there for the money. He's maybe there for those things.
Yeah.
But I still think you kind of need an element of that. Like there's people that want to be social and shit. And if you got five dudes staring at some rich amateur, that guy's like, yeah, I could go.
I feel like you've pulled off still playing hard though. Just watch Tom. Just all tournament players, just watch this guy, you know? Like have a little
now,
a little
not
moxie.
From 10 years ago. Because 10 years ago, I might have been one of the guys that's been.
But that would be, you were just a young pup, you know? I mean, with 98% of yourself, so that's different. I think we'll let you go, right? I mean, anything else? I'm sure you got shit to do, so.
All right, let me ask you one.
Yeah?
Where do you see yourself in 18 months?
18 months? Probably playing some live tournaments. looking at some poker spots with the youngins, hanging out with the baby. I have a little girl now.
Yeah, congrats.
Hanging out with the fam, thank you. And I have a fantasy about commentating boxing one day. We'll see.
Oh, yeah?
I'm knocking on some doors. Why not? I'm a diehard boxing fan. We'll see, I've got the poker thing, you know, maybe a little segue. Long shot, but even if it's 100 to 1, I mean, we'll take it. Try. Right. Let's go, dude.
Yeah, thanks. Corona stuff.
Yeah.